The second part of the circulatory system, that is blood vessels. See, for example, if you have a garden of plants, you want to water the plants. You will be watering the plants by taking the bucket full of water with a jug and will pour the water like this. So that is the one way. And another way, we can use the water pipe. If we have the tap in the garden and we can connect the water pipe to the tap, and then the water pipe, when you open the tap, the water will be supplied, water will be entered into the water pipe, and with the water pipe we can easily pour the water or supply the water to the all the plants. So this is the best way. So this we can compare with the our body circulatory system. Here the tap is the human heart, the water pipe is the blood vessels, and the plants are the human body parts. Okay, when the heart beats and blood is pumped into the blood vessels, and blood vessels will carry the blood into the all the body parts. This is the total systematic nature of the circulatory system of the body. So such a very important thing is there for the blood vessels. Blood vessels are very very important. They carry the blood from heart to the body parts and from the body parts to the heart completely. Okay, and there are three types of blood vessels. Let me write: arteries, veins, and the capillaries. There are the three types of blood vessels: arteries, veins, and the capillaries. Arteries always is the type of blood vessels which carry the blood from heart to all the body parts. Arteries, the function of the arteries is carry the blood from heart to all the body parts. Almost all the arteries will carry the oxygenated blood. Almost all the arteries carry the oxygenated blood, except the pulmonary artery. Except this pulmonary artery, remaining all the arteries carry the oxygenated blood, but the pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood. Deoxygenated blood is carried by pulmonary artery. See, artery's major function is taking the blood or carrying the blood from heart to all the body parts, including the pulmonary artery. It will take the blood from heart to lungs. There it is purified and again sent back to the heart. Okay, so the pulmonary arteries, except this pulmonary arteries, remaining all the arteries carry the oxygenated blood, but this pulmonary artery carry the deoxygenated blood. Okay, and the arteries, when you take the shape and structure of the arteries, arteries are long tube-like structures, and the blood is flowing in the arteries in spurs, means basing on the movement of the ventricles. The ventricles will pump the blood to the arteries. So the movement of the ventricles, the blood movement will be presented in the arteries. It is not continued. The blood movement in the arteries is not continued. Okay, understand? And next, when you take the structure of the arteries, the transverse section of the arteries, if you take that, they have the thick walls. This is the lumen. Lumen, very narrow lumen is presented here. Very narrow lumen is presented here. Very narrow lumen. And the walls are having the three major layers in it. The walls are having the three major layers. This is the tunica externa. This is called tunica. Internal, and this is called as the tunica media. Here the three layers are presented around the root. The outermost layer is called as the tunica externa. It is a muscular connective tissue. It's a muscular connective tissue. Okay, and second of the middle one is called as tunica media, and it is a fibrous structure which is having the flexibility, elasticity. What is that? Elasticity. Okay. And the third layer is called as tunica interna. It is a epithelial tissue. It's an epithelial tissue completely. Totally, these three layers are together called as the walls of the arteries. So the walls of the arteries are very much thick. The walls of the arteries are very much thick and elastic in nature. And they have a narrow lumen so that the flowing of blood or a flowing of blood into the arteries is taking a lot of pressure. That pressure is called as blood pressure or BP. The pressure which is created when the blood is entering into the arteries, the pressure which is created when the blood is entering into the arteries is called as blood pressure. And this pressure is created only because of the arteries have the narrow lumen. Arteries have the narrow lumen so that the blood pressure will be created. And the blood pressure, if the blood pressure is increased at the place of arteries, it will attack the back attack of this blood pressure to the heart, and the heart may fail immediately and the person dies. And simply that is called as a heart attack. Okay, so the blood pressure can be measured by using an instrument is called as a sphygmomanometer. The blood pressure can be measured by using an instrument called as a sphygmomanometer. And the normal person blood BP will be 120 by 80 Hz. 120 by 80 Hz. That is the normal BP of the persons. Okay, and this BP can be checked or measured by using the instrument called as sphygmomanometer. And we will discuss about the what is 120, what is 80 in the coming lessons. Okay, understand. And now the second one is veins. The structure of the veins, the lumen is a wide lumen is presented there. Wide lumen, the lumen is wider, wide lumen. So this is the structure of the veins. Veins are having the wide lumen. You see the wide lumen, you can see that. You can see the comparison between the arteries and veins. Wide lumen, and have the tunica, the outermost layer is called as tunica externa. And this is a muscular layer. And the middle one is called tunica media. It is a fiber-like layer, but non-elastic. There the arteries, it is elastic, but here it is non-elastic. And innermost layer is called as the tunica interna. There are the three layers are presented in the veins. The lumen is very much wider so that there is no pressure. There is no pressure that is created by blood. The blood flow is continuously occur in the veins. But the veins are having the valve-like structures, pocket-like structures are presented. Those are called as valves. Valve, it is a structure where it allows the material to go forward. It won't out another material to come back once again. So that is called as valve, and this type of valves are presented in the veins so that the blood is always flowing forward direction. It never comes back. So if you put your any of your friends upside down like this also, the blood won't come down because the walls of the veins will not allow the blood to come down. Okay, understand? That is the veins, and all the veins will carry the blood from the blood body parts to the heart. All the veins carry the blood from body parts to the heart, except the pulmonary vein. It will carry the oxygenated blood. It carries oxygenated blood. All the veins carry the deoxygenated blood from the all the body parts to the heart. They bring the blood, except the pulmonary vein. The pulmonary vein carries the oxygenated blood from the lungs, and it brings to the left ventricle, left auricle of the heart. Okay, so arteries will carry the blood from heart to the all the body parts, and veins are carry the blood from body parts to the heart. I think, is it clear? Okay, next we'll move to the third one, that is your capillaries. These are the tiny tube-like projections, tube-like structures. Moreover, these are the modifications of the arteries and veins. Arteries and the veins, those are called as capillaries, and we don't have these three layers in it. Only one layer is presented around the lumen, that is the tunia interna. It is made up of epithelial tissue. We have the tiny tubules like structures which act as a bridge between the arteries and veins, and arteries and body parts to the veins. Okay, that is the capillaries. Understand? And now, next class we are going to discuss about the blood groups. Okay.